remember back when you were first learning arithmetic, you know, addition and multiplication? I don't. I mean, that was 30 years ago. But, you know, you probably do, because it's a lot more recent for you than for me. But you remember that addition was pretty easy, right? Addition was, the only thing that was even remotely complicated was carrying, and that wasn't too hard. Multiplication, though, that was a real pain. You had all these times tables, and you had the complicated, you know, multi-digit multiplication. What a pain. Well, in fractions, it's kind of the opposite. In fractions, multiplying fractions is easy. It's addition. It's kind of a pain. We'll get to the addition later. First, we're going to do multiplication, because that's the easy part. We like doing the easy stuff first. All right, so here we go. We're going to start with an example, of course. 3/5 times 7. How do we do that? Well, we go back to what's our definition of a fraction. It's just a number. We remember that, right? Fraction is a number. It's the number 3 divided by 5. So let's go ahead and write that. 3/5 is 3 divided by 5. And then we're going to multiply this by 7. Well, 3 divided by 5, we can turn that into a multiplication problem using our definition of division. This is just 3 times 1 over 5. And then times 7. Now, of course, one of the nice things about having a multiplication problem is we can multiply in whatever order we want to. We can rearrange these. We can put the 3 and the 7 together because we know how to multiply those. And 3 times 7, that's 21. 21 times 1 over 5. 21 times 1 over 5, we're multiplying by a reciprocal. That's just division. 21 divided by 5. And 21 divided by 5, 21 divided by 5, that's what a fraction is. It's just a division. So our answer to 3 over 5 times 7 is just 21 over 5. 3 times 7 is 21. 5 on the bottom. Maybe that's a coincidence. Let's try something a little more complicated. Let's try actually multiplying two fractions instead of a fraction times an integer. Let's try this, and we'll do the same thing, right? Because we have all these nice rules for division and multiplication. We'll write this as a division, 3 divided by 5, because that's what a fraction is, times another division. So we've turned this into division and multiplication because we can handle that. Now we'll turn each of these divisions into a multiplication, because we know that we can then reorder our multiplication. 3 divided by 5 is just 3 times the reciprocal of 5. 7 divided by 2 is 7 times the reciprocal of 2. Now we're going to reorder this, put this in an order we can handle. We're going to put the 3 and the 7 together. And we know how to multiply reciprocals. 1 over 5 times 1 over 2. We'll put those together as well. 3 times 7 is still 21. And 1 over 5 times 1 over 2 is 1 over 10. 21 times the reciprocal, that's division. 21 divided by 10. 21 divided by 10. 21 divided by 10. It's a division. That means it's a fraction. We can write it as 21 over 10. And that's our answer. This number, fraction is a number. 3 over 5 times 7 over 2. 3 times 7 is 21. 5 times 2 is 10. Let's see if that always works. We'll take any fraction here, a over b times c over d. B and d can't be 0, no dividing by 0. And we'll do the same thing we did before. All we're doing is, really isn't anything new. We're just using our division and multiplication rules. Write this as a divided by b times c divided by d. And we're going to go through the same steps we just did. One thing I like to do when I'm trying to find something new, I work through a couple examples, and then I just copy the examples, replace all the numbers with letters, and see if the same steps work. And that's all we're doing here. A divided by B is A times the reciprocal of B. C divided by D is C times the reciprocal of D. Reorder this. Put the A and the C together. That's why we like turning everything into a multiplication. Put the B and the D together. We know how to multiply these reciprocals, and we get AC times the reciprocal of BD. Multiplying by reciprocal, you've heard this a couple times already. That's just division. And what's a division? Division is a fraction. AC divided by BD is just AC over BD. A times C over B times D. And look at that. This really isn't anything new. All we're doing here is using our definition of a fraction, just a division. And then we're using all the rules we already knew for multiplication and division. And we see that when we multiply two fractions, what we do is we multiply the tops and we multiply the bottoms. That's all there is to it. We get AC over BD, and we are done.